Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. What's coming next inside of FIFA 22 Ultimate Team? Road to the Knockouts is ending. We have a Team of the Week 6 today. And we know what has been happening with these. The second week of these promos ending on a Wednesday. We get a loading screen at some point on Wednesday, another one on Thursday, and then a promo on Friday. So what I'm hoping for today is to get a loading screen for what could be Ultimate Scream or a Rulebreakers coming this Friday. Of course, we expect a promo, right? Promos every single Friday is the new wave inside of FIFA. We 100% expect it. It's just a matter of what is that promo going to be. So I want to talk a little bit about that today. Maybe what to look out for in terms of a loading screen. What's going to happen to the market and Team of the Week 6 today. I want to start off by talking about this. It's going to be a crazy day today for Team of the Week 6. Because so many people have saved their Team of the Week packs. And when you have saved Team of the Week packs, you have a lot of market movements and actually a ton of potential for profit. So first of all, I want to take a look at a couple Team of the Week 6 predictions. If we have not looked at them already on the videos, this Team of the Week, of course, led by Salah, is expected to be very top heavy, right? Salah at the top, Upamecano and Alaba. And then after that, it just looks very meh, right? It looks like a very average Team of the Week coming once again. But regardless, people are not going to be able to save their Team of the Week packs. And I think they're going to still, a lot of people are still going to open their Team of the Week packs today at 6 p.m. because they've been holding, because they didn't open this last week when the most expensive player in the team was 40,000 coins in Firmino. So I do think you'll see a lot of people opening today. Salah, of course, being the headliner. Couple ones to watch cards. We'll talk about those as well. But other than that, Mason Mount, TOTW maybe being in the team. This is the foot head prediction. Josh King. I don't even know who's going to be the featured upgrade this week. I really have no idea who it's going to be. If we look ahead at the foot bin prediction, I'll zoom in on this a little bit so it's easier to see. Diego Simeone looks like he might be the one. Or actually, I don't even know if his first name is Diego. I'm just saying Diego Simeone. Simeone with the 84 rated card, that looks to be Footbin's, I guess, idea of the featured Team of the League card. They've got Salah, Mount, Upa, Alaba, Coates, Poulsen in there as well. So, you know, it just really does not look like that great of a Team of the League. We will see what ends up happening. But again, one thing I want to talk about, this happened with Team of the Week 4, if you guys remember or not. Now, I know Team of the Week 4 is a sore spot in a lot of you guys' minds because Team of the Week 4 has been basically a Team of the Week that has just never risen. Now, this Rafinha has actually gone up a little bit with Firmino, but I mean, these cards just continued to drop while they were in packs. So many people lost coins on these Team of the Week cards. But if you guys remember, when they first came out, people had saved their Team of the Week packs for Team of the Week number 4, because Team of the Week 3 was just not good. Of course, Team of the Week 4 had the likes of Mane, had Teo Hernandez, cards like that. They were in this Team of the Week 4. And what happened with those cards, specifically some of the meta lower tier cards like Romero, like that Rafinha, and those types of items that were on the market right away on Wednesday, is that they dropped in price drastically. There's so much supply in that first 15 to 20 to 30 minutes of people ripping open their Team of the Week packs, listing their cards up. It just plummets the price of these informs right away. Then you have all that supply stopping and a lot of people like, okay, I actually want to go out and try these cards on this market because they look pretty good. So we're looking out for a similar situation with that today, specifically on a guy like Salah, right? Salah might be one that could happen. Upamecano would be a card today that I would keep an eye on for sure. Now, one thing I'd be very careful with is for the rest of the Team of the Week that drops today, just be very, very careful. If you're trying to find some fluctuation with that supply, there's going to be a lot of people looking to make that trade today, right? So you're going to have to time it perfectly. A lot of people are going to be looking to buy. Probably going to be some Patreon involvement in there. So once a card hits a low point and people start buying, it's going to shoot up quick, but then you're going to want to sell very quickly. I remember doing this with that same Team in League 4. I bought Depay's at like 95,000 coins, and he went up to 120K in like 15 minutes time, but then he started plummeting back down under 90K within just a few, you know, like an hour or so after that, because everybody kept relisting. Again, with all that supply that's coming in, this is going to be a very short and quick flipping scenario on the new Team of the Weeks that come out today. Speaking again of those Team of the Weeks, Upamecano and David Alaba ones to watch. There is one thing and one thing only that I am doing with these cards right now. Upamecano back at 190. I am selling in the hype, 100% selling into the hype, just because these cards are going to get supplied so much right away today. Their informs are going to come on the market and be cheap. I know this Upamecano is going to look crazy good and he's going to be insane, but you still have so many other alternatives for cards in this game, like Kimpembe at 60,000 coins, who is arguably better than this Upamecano. Even after an upgrade, Upamecano is going to look interesting. He's going to be very hyped, but the amount of people that have this ones to watch item, you are selling that in the hype today, okay? That's the only option. You're selling in the hype. Now, whatever happens later on, he might drop and then rebound. That, there is potential for that. But before content today, I would sell and take the easy cash. We do not mess with supply in this game, right? We sell into the hype, right? That's a big golden rule of FIFA, and it's even bigger this year. Same thing with David Alaba. I sold mine at 65K. I could have held out for another like 3,000 coins, it looks like. He's about 68, 69,000 coins. Alaba's going to get himself a plus two today on his inform if he gets in team of the week. His card will look really good, but again, I'm selling into the hype because this was like a 28,000 coin card, and now he's almost 70,000 coins. So selling the hype on these guys. Watch for their prices to drop off. See where the informs are. They might rise back a little bit, but the informs are definitely going to come in on the market. I think they should be cheaper than those ones to watches. So that would be 100% my thing to tell you to do with those cards today. And again, watch that team of the week six in the first hour or so, because it's going to get crazy. It's really going to get crazy on the market today in terms of that. Now, other things that we see on Wednesdays, selling. We see selling on Wednesdays, every single Wednesday like clockwork. Every single Wednesday we see selling because people get ready for Division Rivals rewards, right? Those rewards come out Thursday morning, and what you see is people start preparing on Wednesday for that. Literally every single week this game has been out, we've watched Wednesday, the Index 100 on Footbin, reach a high right around 6 p.m. UK on a Wednesday and start to drop off as people get ready for that Rivals Rewards time frame. So I would expect the same thing today. If there's any cards that are in your team today that are up in price, a lot of golds, you know, maybe have, you know, dropped down a slight bit, but a lot of these RTTK Team 2 cards people are investing in, I'm not investing in these cards. I think in my liking, they might rise up a little bit in the next couple of days, but I think that's why it's going to be short-lived when we have a new promo coming and we're going to have a loading screen potentially today. So I don't want to mess with that. So I mean, if there's stuff that is up in your team right now, we know what happens on Fridays with the supply, on Saturdays, right? Fridays, Saturdays with all that supply, especially with 50K packs being in the game now, it looks like. Last weekend, we had 50Ks on Friday, and that killed a lot of the gold prices on this game even more. I would be taking the cash on your gold cards in packs. Again, Bruno was like 65K, dropped down to 49 because of that 50K pack supply. It was crazy, right? So if that happens again this weekend, these cards are, again, going to drop another increment. So I would be cashing out on gold cards that you have in your teams. I mean, Gold Sun, 230, is that an undercut? Okay, that's a 10K undercut, because I was going to say he has gone from like 220 to 250 this week. But that is an undercut on Sonaldo. So I would be still taking the cash on these cards this morning. Out of packs, informs maybe as well. I would look to take a little bit of the cash on, specifically those ones to watches. Icons, you know, icons will still be decent trades, but you might see them drop off in price a little bit this morning and into today on the game as well on Wednesday. And regardless, on Wednesday, Team of the Week Wednesdays, especially in the second week. I remember the second week of the ones to watch promo, it was very, very quiet, right? And this week has been very, very quiet in terms of content. No player picks. We did have the team league upgrade. This expires basically today on a Wednesday. This is going away, so no more team league upgrade. And the Philip Kostic SBC is what we had yesterday. I wasn't even expecting this, and they dropped this SBC, which the stats in this card look great and is very, very cheap. But I mean, to be honest with you, the 3-star skills and the 2-star weak foot make this card a lot less usable than his stats suggest, unless you don't mind those two glaring weaknesses on the card. But maybe for a left back, if you want to position change him in your team in game, or maybe he's maybe even as like a box to box sub, super sub in the midfield, he could be pretty good. His card looks great. It's just the weak foot and the skills that really let him down. But at a cheap price, you know, with a couple upgrades that he could eventually get upgraded to like an 88. You know, then, you know, some people might be looking into doing that card, but it's been a relatively quiet week of content on this game. And I think that's going to continue today on Wednesday. I really don't think the biggest thing that would spice today up is, and probably will be, the loading screen, because I do think that we are going to see a loading screen today. Now, what you can kind of watch for is see if they start to take away these loading screens. Last week, they didn't drop us a loading screen until they didn't drop it right away, I'm pretty sure. I think they delayed it a couple of hours until they started to show us the road to the knockout, like the upgrade stuff, right? And we saw the live cards that were on the screen. They showed us the road to the UCL, UEFA, and the Conference League road to the knockout cards. So watch out for a loading screen today. Anytime from 6 p.m. to 9 to 10 p.m. UK, they could upload something on the front screen of FIFA. That could cause a little bit of panic because, again, what we're expecting as one of the next two promos would be, I think the highest percentage chance of a promo to drop on Friday would be this Rulebreakers promo, or what we also know as Ultimate Scream. I don't know if they're going to call it Scream this year. Of course, last year they called it Rule Breakers, but it had the same vibes, right? It had the same exact vibes as Ultimate Scream with some big upgrades, as they said. Permanent targeted attribute boosts that break the norms of football, right? It has that Scream vibe to it. They just didn't call it Scream last year. So we will see if they do that again this year. Of course, you can see this is their graphic last year, right? They gave Kane like the huge agility balance upgrade. The Marcus Llorente card last year was just so cracked. This, like, Marcus Llorente had a great gold card, and then he got this insane Rulebreakers item, and everybody was all over it. So, again, the most, I guess, the highest chance of a loading screen today on Wednesday would be for a Rulebreakers slash a Scream promo. Now, of course, we've heard the rumors of that, like, Adidas promo coming, but I'm pretty sure that when EA talked about it, that promo was not going to be released until, like, later in November. So that would be, like, I guess, a runner-up for the next potential promo that we might see on this game. Now, something that I'm seeing right now on this game that is still ridiculous to me, another thing that we need to talk about at the moment, is this Renan Lodi. If you guys did not know, this Renan Lodi has been extinct the entire time that he has been on the market, which has been since Sunday. And he's about to go out of packs and not even see the market, which I think is honestly crazy, right? Now, we know, this is confirmed, we know that price ranges are not updated manually by somebody at EA typing in the price ranges, right? EA has a system that updates price ranges like a computer, right? The same kind of system that would ban somebody from the transfer market once they exceed some limits. Whatever computer system they have set up to upgrade this Renan Lodi price range, it needs to happen, man. Like, this card literally has not accessed the market. And I really hope that it gets upgraded today. If it doesn't, that just, it looks even worse. So it has not been updated as of yet, but this could be something that we do see as well. I guess that would be market content for today on Wednesday on this game. So just keep an eye out for that. Other than that, I really do think it's going to be a pretty quiet Wednesday. Team of the week, there's going to be a lot of movements on the market for that. A lot of prices are probably starting to drop into the later part of the day, right? This morning, Wednesday morning, might be a time to get out on some stuff, finish up some last minute flips that you may have had, flipping icons, ones to watches. A lot of players on this game, and I want to make this known at the moment too, a lot of investors went out and bought up these RTTK2 cards yesterday on this game. Tapsoba was 30K, he's now 33. Amavi is up 3K a card. Jesus Navas was 100,000 coins, he's now 112. A lot of these cards of, like, literally the entire team was boosted up a little bit yesterday, almost like 5 to 10% on most of them. They went up in price as people invested in them. Now, if you're somebody who invested in these, you're hoping for no loading screen today. You're hoping for, like, no promo this weekend, because that is, like, the only chance, in my opinion, that these cards boom like Road to the Knockouts Team 1 did. So I'm a little worried about RTTK Team 2, and I don't like investing in this year, right? I just like to trade, and that's about it. Quick ins and quick outs. That's all we like to do in this FIFA, because everything else is a lot more risky with the supply. So just be careful, and that's my, I guess you could say, word of warning, if you will, to if you have invested into an RTTK Team 2 card. Now, I think some of them could do pretty good, but I'm just a little bit worried about it, man. So if you've got gold cards in your team, I mean, honestly, any gold card, you know, if it's a card that's going out of packs today for Team of the Week, like Gold Salah, I haven't even taken much of a chance to look at this guy's price, but even for some of these gold cards, I'm selling into the hype, right? I'm selling into the hype on Gold Salah, 360,000 coins for this gold version of Mohamed Salah on the market at the moment, which I do kind of want to take a look at his price. I mean, you probably have also the versions of Upamecano and David Alaba are up because people are expecting their card to go out of packs today as a gold item. I'd be cashing those as well. So Salah has gone from 330 to about 360. So if you got this card gold, I'm still cashing it. I'm still 100% cashing it, because if we do get a Salah inform again today, that's going to make his inform crash. If we get a 91 Salah inform, or even a record breaker if they wanted to do that, that's going to make this 90 rated card, who's been already 550k, he's going to drop off again. Watch out for panic selling on this item of Salah. He was 550k MPS, bounced back to 620 with more anticipated second inform hype for Salah. Watch out for selling on the inform. But that makes me want to sell the gold card too, right? With the supply this year, it's already up 30k if you got in right away. So I'd be dishing that out as well if you could. Same thing on Alaba. I know for 100% that his card is probably 2,400 coins. Yeah, he was like, looks like he was about 1,600, 1,700, and boom, now he's 2,400. I would cash that out for sure. And I'm sure the same thing is happening with Upamecano, who is still a really cheap card in this game. 5,000 coins, and he was 3K. Yeah, I'm taking the cash, boys, 100%. With the supply this year the way that it is, sell in the hype, man. That's the rule, right? Remember those words, sell in to the hype. So that's the video for today, boys, right? Loading screen could cause a little bit of panic alongside of with the normal market drop-off we see on Wednesdays. New team of the week is going to be very interesting to trade with. I hope they throw somebody in there to make it hype other than Salah and the two wants to watch cards. Fingers crossed that they do. And then again, that loading screen is what we're really waiting for to kind of figure out what's going to happen on this game in the next couple of days as we head into the weekend. So once we get that information, we'll be talking about it. Of course, we'll be live on streaming on Twitch. Check that link down below in the description if you want to tackle the team of the week and watch the loading screen come up with us tomorrow on this game. But that is the video for today, boys. If you did enjoy, smash your thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you have questions, and subscribe if you're new. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. I will catch you guys later. Peace.